I first heard about this tragedy, I jumped to the conclusion that I think many did, that there was some racial aspect to this shooting, that Trayvon Martin was shot and killed by George Zimmerman, in part based upon bigotry and racial profiling. And I just presumed that from all the press reports that came out and from what I'd heard. Well, as I started getting into our role as an analyst and such, I started asking questions. I've been a defense lawyer for over 30 years and have come to realize that much of what you hear is simply not factual. So we've got the picture there, and you can see I had a family member give it to a friend who gave it to me, and we gave it to you earlier today. And as you see there, the man in the middle is apparently George Zimmerman's great-grandfather. The woman above him is, in fact, his grandmother, who's half black, and the little child in the gentleman's lap is his mother. So we see that he really has significant multiracial, multicultural roots. And as I've come to realize and find out through my investigation, he was raised in a multicultural, integrated family, in large part by his grandmother, who's half black. And I've made the analogy, and it seems appropriate that if President Obama has indicated that if his son would have looked like Trayvon Martin, then most respectfully, if you look at these pictures, his grandparents and great-grandparents would have looked a lot like George Zimmerman's grandparents and great-grandparents. So it seems to me, in light of this and other things that we've found out about him mentoring African-American children quietly with nobody knowing about it for a couple of years, driving from Sanford to Orlando regularly and then talking to people that know him, I have changed my position. People can come up with whatever conclusions they want, but from looking at the facts, looking at the evidence, I don't think there's a racial motive.